So today we're going to be talking about apples in a pot. That's up next. Hello everyone, this is Dwayne with Edge of Nowhere Farm, and we're coming to you here this morning. It is third week of June 2020. So we, as you guys know, we have a lot of fruit trees in our past. Now, on the new property, maybe not quite so many. We've got a few in the ground, but we don't have much in the way of harvest going on this year. However, we do have one tree that's ready to give us a harvest, and that is our Golden Dorset apple tree right here in this pot. So what I'm gonna do before I forget, I'm gonna go ahead and link a video here, and it was shot a couple years ago, going on 3 years this fall, when we actually put this tree into this pot. So you can actually watch us planting it. So here we are 2.5 years later, and we're actually gonna be taking our very first harvest off of this tree. So one of the things that we always have people asking us is, how do we grow certain things in pots or in smaller spaces? And for the majority of people, you don't have 6 acres to work with, and that it can be a disadvantage if you want to look at it that way, or an advantage. So for me, we first had our first home on 5,000 total square feet. The home itself was about 1,800, typical home in a subdivision. And I think we had 13 or 14 fruit trees in the ground there. Now, that was learning how to do this 8 years ago, and obviously we've come a long way since then. However, one of the huge advantages to having that small space is you get to kind of play around and kind of do some things that you wouldn't typically do with trees. Pruning them different ways, obviously you can plant them in different areas, you can also put them into pots. So one of the things that we wanted to do here on this farm is test a few things out that we could share with you guys out there that you can maybe incorporate into a smaller space. So obviously one of the ways to do that would be growing trees in pots. So looking at trees and trees specifically in pots, really kind of the first thing you probably want to consider is obviously what you want to grow. Now, there are certain types of fruit trees that would probably do better in a pot. Obviously, when you're talking about bushes, so vining plants, those would probably be your best bet. So things like blackberries, raspberries, blueberries, smaller bushes obviously would work really well. Next thing you'd probably want to look at, things that would typically grow more slowly or have rootstocks that are designed for it. So you would have a rootstock, let's say a dwarfing rootstock on a type of citrus, say like a kumquat, and that particular variety on a dwarfing rootstock and a tree that typically would be more of a dwarf would be a fantastic choice for putting in a pot, and you'd get a good amount of production out of a tree like that. Now, what we're doing here is something completely different. So this tree we actually purchased from Reed at RSI Growers. I'll link a video here. We've talked about him multiple times. The majority of our trees are going to come from him here on the new farm. And this is one of the trees that we actually got from him. Now, the rootstock, that's specifically designed for our soil. And that's not what we have in this pot. It's also a full-size tree. So that rootstock is very aggressive. It's designed to create a nice big tree that we would have here in the ground. And of course, that's definitely not our situation here. However, all that being considered, you can see just how well this tree is doing. Now, we do have it in a cement pot. We have found that the typical pots you would get here in Arizona at least degrade very, very quickly. We've tried wine barrels. We actually have a couple of clay pots that are behind me here that are temporarily housing a couple of mulberry trees. But we have found that the cement pots actually do pretty well. They're the only ones that really hold up. We've had no issues whatsoever, as you can see, with the tree growing in it. Now, placement, we did have this particular potted tree at the old farm placed right in the middle of our vineyard garden. So on the old farm, this tree got full sun all day long. It never got a break, with the exception of in the evening for the last maybe hour or so, it would get a little bit of break from the sun. Otherwise, this thing just got blasted with the sun. Now, we also have always hand watered this. We've never had irrigation running to it, so we always have watered it by hand. And here in the middle of summer, we basically water this tree essentially every day. Now, we have a nice layer of wood chips on there, so that's a big part of maintaining the soil moisture. But considering this is in a cement pot, the tree itself getting baked and the fact that it does this well will tell you they can definitely survive. So as far as the tree, we also do prune it. Now this past winter, I didn't come through and have time to prune this. We were getting everything going here on the new farm. But this winter, I definitely will probably do a video on pruning this. We need to get this thing growing more vertical. You can see just how wide it's gotten. So it's a very, very wide tree. For this pot, obviously, we'd prefer it to be more vertical. And I've got some vertical growth that's starting here. However, we did prune it winter before last, and that allowed the tree to start developing some fruiting spurs, and that's where we actually are going to be taking our harvest today. So let's go ahead and take a peek at the handful of apples we have here on this potted apple tree. Okay, so here we are. We have two little groupings of apples. I have one little group here. You can see there's three apples here, and not very big, and that's probably just because of it being in a pot. I did thin this particular little bunch here. It was a bunch of five or six, so I thinned it back to three. Probably should have thinned it back to two, but I wanted to make sure we had a couple of nice little apples in there. And then I have another bunch of two right here, so you can see those two apples there. And this one, we're actually getting a decent size on that, but these are much, much smaller than we would typically get on our in-ground Golden Dorset apple trees. So I'm gonna go ahead and pick one of these so we can take a look at it, and I think this one's probably the most ripe. Now, if Lori wants to squeeze in just a little bit, I'm gonna show you this, because a lot of people ask us about Golden Dorset apples and when are they ripe. Now, today is, I think we're the 21st of June, it's Father's Day 2020. So to give you an idea of timing, this is typically when we would remove all the apples from the tree. This particular fruit, hopefully you can make it up with the sun, but it's starting to yellow right here on the top of the apple. This would be the oldest part. This is the newer part of the apple. So the oldest part or most mature part of the apple is turning yellow. That's definitely a good indicator that this particular fruit is starting to ripen. And timing. So we're starting to get into the monsoon season. And what we found with these apples is you can pick them underripe. So when they're still gonna be a little more tart. However, they go mealy very, very quickly. So if you leave them on the tree too long, you're gonna be dealing with a mealy apple. Now, if you're making wine or cider or something, a mealy apple is not a big deal. If you're eating them fresh or juicing them, obviously a more crisp apple is really what you're gonna probably prefer. And we found that this third week of June is really kind of ideal for us, typically here in Arizona. So I'm gonna go ahead and harvest this. Now, another thing too, for anybody who's has not had apples before or harvested apples, the easiest thing to do when you're actually picking an apple off of a tree so you don't damage the tree is you can cut this, so you can cut the stem, or when you pull it, you just kind of pull, I don't know how to describe this, but against the little nub here. You can see I've got an apple here and an apple here. So what I'm gonna do is I just wanna basically pull back. And you can, and that's okay, you can leave a little bit of that, but just kinda, we wanna make sure you're not pulling back on the tree. So either cut it or just snip it off there. I'm gonna go ahead and take this one too. Again, pull against it and it pops right off and it leaves those little nubs and that would be just fine. All right, so now I have two little apples and of course, what we need to do more than anything is see how these taste. But before I eat one of these, I'm gonna go ahead and get the rest of my harvest off the tree. Okay, so you get an idea of the harvest that we're getting off of this little tree. So again, fruit size, definitely not nearly as big as you would get on a full grown tree. But this one here is actually not that bad. And this is the one I was showing you. You can see it has a little bit of russeting. That's this kind of dry, kind of scaly skin here at the top, which is fine. And then of course the yellowing, you can see it's slightly yellowing there and still pretty green there. Overall though, I think this one's actually gonna be really good. So let's go ahead and take a look. I'm gonna cut this open so we can see what it looks like on the inside. Okay, so I didn't get quite a center cut on that, which is okay. I'm gonna go ahead and just kind of quarter this a little bit. There we go. So you can see here, not much in the way of seeds. I didn't get a very good cut on it, but I kind of wanted to show you the actual flesh itself. So I don't know whether you can see it in the sun, but you can see it's nice and juicy, nice and firm too. So it's a really good apple as far as that firmness, and I could see the juiciness there. But you know what? In the end, that doesn't matter too much. Let's see how it tastes. Really good. Definitely a little underripe, which we expected. So Golden Dorset apples, they are, I guess the best way to describe them would be closest to a Granny Smith. So definitely more tart than sweet. Nice and firm, nice and crisp, very juicy. This one has, because it's underripe, it's got a little bit of kind of starchiness to it that you would typically get with an underripe fruit. But the flavor is very good. Again, probably closest to a Granny Smith would be my description for this, but really good. Yeah, oh man, nice and juicy. And you can tell, like I was saying, these will get mealy fast, but definitely not mealy. So nice and crisp, nice and juicy, more tart than sweet, a little bit of starchiness. So what I think we're gonna do is we're gonna take the rest of the harvest, at least that I didn't cut open, put those on the counter, let them ripen for a day or two, and then throw them in the fridge, and then we'll probably use those for juicing. But you can see, got a couple year old tree in a pot producing apples here in Arizona. Amazing. Okay, so I think what we're gonna do, Lori and I have talked about this, so this tree, obviously we've had it for a couple years now, and while we have the space here to definitely keep this kind of tree into the ground, and it would do much better in the ground, I think what we're gonna do is go ahead and keep it in a pot and just kind of see how it does. I don't plan on doing a lot as far as some of the things typically you would do with a tree in a pot. I can hope some people will come through and trim the roots and do some of these things. I don't think I'm gonna do that. I think I'm gonna do kind of the lazy man's version of a potted tree and just kind of see how it does. And then obviously we'll give you guys updates as we go. However, having apples for the first time here on this farm because of a Golden Dorset apple tree that we kept in a pot on the old farm, that's pretty cool. So just want to thank you for joining us today. If you haven't done so already, subscribe to the channel. Questions or comments, leave those in the comment section down below. Instagram and Facebook, we post content there you won't see here on the YouTube channel. And our Amazon shop, I'll leave a link down in the description. That's a free, painless way to help support the channel. If you start with that link, it doesn't matter what you buy, you help to support us here. So just want to thank you for joining us today and remind you, if we can farm on the edge of nowhere, so can you. Good. Yeah, I mean, literally I could see bees like coming out of the pot over here. I mean, they're obviously just trying to get water, but they're like literally all over behind us. So it's pretty cool. Golden Dorset apples. So Golden. I'm gonna keep going.